been dedicated subspace channel 222 AA7.
Use of this frequency requires diplomatic
voice print authorize. Burnham. Michael.
Confirmed.
Commander Burnham.
Hello, Sarek. I'm happy to see you.
So many years.
And still you allow emotional considerations to impede your logic.
They inform my logic. I need your help.
I assume the timing of the call was not coincidental. The Quadrant reports a new star in the sky.
What have you done out there on the edge of Federation space?
We've encountered the Klingons.
How rare to meet one's own demons in the flesh.
I killed one.
In light of the fact that they killed your parents, some might think that only fair. However,
if a death was necessary, I am satisfied it was not yours. I'm most certain you did not call me for emotional solace.
We're facing off. No fire has been exchanged. But they didn't turn on that beacon until Starfleet was on its way to our position. I think they're summoning more of their kind.
An odd proposition, given that their empire has been in disarray for generations.
But you are describing something out of the ordinary.
Restraint in the face of conflict, when a civilization acts in opposition to its instincts. Maybe under the influence of something or someone new.
Great unifiers.
Few and far between, but they do come.
Often such leaders will need a profound cause for their followers to rally around.
A war.
Be very careful that your assumptions are not being driven by your past.
This isn't about what happened, Sarek. It's what's happening now. How did the Vulcans achieve diplomatic relations with the Klingons?
That is a solution particular to us. One cannot assume it would work on a ship commanded by humans.
Sarek, please.
I caution you. Be considered with how you use this information. You cannot save lives that have already been lost.
Tell me, how did you keep the Klingons at bay?